What's up, guys? So we have a treat for you today. As you saw in our thumbnail picture, we got something in that we've been waiting for a very, very long time. Was very complicated to get. It was not easy at all. And with SEMA going on and everything else popping up this time of year, we got World Cup Finals going on this week. SEMA's going on. We got PRI coming up soon. So I guess the company that made these for me decided to knock them out right towards the end of the year, which I'm grateful for. I honestly didn't think I was going to get them till the beginning of the year. I got them, surprisingly, I received the email and the tracking number was on the way and they shipped to me and we received them. So in these three boxes, we have three billet crankshafts. So two of them are for me. One of them is for a very good friend of ours that is going to be running a 3S GTE as well. 5S, 3S combo, like you know, we love to do. So what I'm going to do now is open these boxes up. They're actually all sealed. And let's open this up so you guys can check it out. All right, so they did a very good job at boxing them up so they're nice and safe on their journey here. And these are all USA made, no Chinese crankshafts here. All right, got this box opened up, and this is what they look like when they are shipped. So, brand new chromoly, not forged, full billet, 3S GTE crankshafts. That, again, man, we've been, as many of you know, we are trying to come back with our old school drag AE86. This was one of the missing links that I basically put all my effort into, and if I didn't get a crankshaft, a billet crankshaft, we know that the factory cranks, we made good power with those cranks. We made about 1140 many years ago. You can look at some of the videos we have, and it was a great crankshaft, but that's not what we're trying to do. In the drag racing stuff that we do, we compete with a lot of the two rotor guys, and those guys are honestly flying. So they all have billet cranks and those two rotor setups, billet plates, billet housings, you name it. They're making everything for those rotaries. So we have to be able to compete. Without a billet crank, we just would not have been able to take it to the next level that we wanted to. So my biggest goal was, I wanted to finish the car. I didn't really invest any time into that. I've been getting a lot of work done trying to get, you know, produce some money so I could come up with the funds to basically figure out where I was going to get crankshafts from, first of all, and then have them made. So, and again, I don't want, you know, to be competitive in the sport compact stuff that we're doing. One engine is not going to do it. So my biggest goal from the beginning of this year actually was going out and making sure that we can get two crankshafts. So that's exactly what we did. And it's the same company I've always used. It's an American made company. Like I said, unfortunately, I can't release their name. They actually don't want to make them anymore. And if they do, they're not cheap whatsoever. So at PRI, I'm hoping to talk to them to see if they're willing to maybe produce a few more. I have some other guys who are interested, and see if hopefully I can convince them to do it. But let's take this thing out the box and check it out. All right, here you go. Give you guys a up close and personal shot. As you can see, this thing, man, it is absolutely gorgeous. This thing is really just honestly, it's beautiful. I mean, we've made them before when we used to race the Starlet, and I was very happy with the quality. And again, you cannot beat the quality of this thing and how much power it will handle. So when I spoke to the crank guys, I told them I want this thing to basically handle 1800 horsepower, and that's the plan. You know, we're hoping we can make upwards of 1600. We know what the Starlet did before, and I know what this motor could do with today's technology, a lot of things that we've learned, and just to step things up. So what a lot of you guys are probably thinking is that this is a stroker crank, and it actually is not. So if you look here, you can see PSI Racing. If you look there, look at the stroke, 3.386. So we're using a factory 86 millimeter stroke. Everything else you can see when the, actually they just finished them, 10/26/22. So again, super excited. You see right there, it says billet. Nothing crazy, nothing super trick about it, other than it just being super strong. One of the areas where we told them we needed strength was a lot of the aftermarket crank companies. If you go back to some of my old videos where you'll see some of the cranks I have posted up there, the cranks will flex in this area. So what we did was basically leave the counterweight all the way through and keep as much material as possible. And that way we know we shouldn't have any flexing in this area as far as from the main journal up into the rod journal. So this area is all very strong. Some of the cranks we had before, we did have them lightened, that they drilled a hole right through here. Actually all the way through. They went all the way through and they did it the same this way. And we didn't want that. So this crank actually is 4 pounds lighter than a factory 3S crank, just the way you see it. So full billet chromoly crankshaft. We had them knife edge. If you ever seen a 3S crank, it kind of is the same way. Let me show you guys a 3S crank. So here's a brand new 3S crank. This is for that NA motor. And you can see where Toyota originally kind of did some knife edging on the leading and trailing edge of the crankshaft. So Toyota, obviously they know what they're doing. One thing I love about Toyota is they do things like that, and a lot of the guys don't even know that they incorporate these kind of ideas and you know, engineering ideas involved in these crankshafts and a lot of engine parts that are just super badass, man. So we took it to the next level with the billet crank, where again we had them knife edge the leading and the trailing edge, and they just basically took it to a point. Just basically help cut down on windage when this thing's spinning the RPM we hope it's gonna spin. And just again, man, super, super pumped. So like I said before, this is one of two crankshafts that we are gonna have. There is three here. And yeah, we plan on having, my main goal is to have two complete 3S motors. So I already have the blocks. I got the cranks now. I already have the connecting rods. I got plenty of cylinder heads. So we're definitely coming out to make a stand and show what these engines can do and get back on top of the 3S game and show everybody, you know, what they're about. So again, super excited with these things, man. I hope you guys can really appreciate it from the video. I'm not sure if you can, but this thing is just absolutely beautiful. And we are definitely gonna see what this thing can do. And again, try and be as competitive as possible. That's the plan. If you're not competitive, then what's the point? Not really trying to go and break any records, because that's where things get actually very expensive when you start doing that. And but you never know what comes out of it. So first off is making sure we have all the best products we can, within reason. Obviously things take time, you know, you can't just spend this kind of money and do it within a matter of 6 months. So at least I can't. So luckily I have my wife's support, my family's support, a lot of guys out there, thank you to all the sponsors that are out there that have helped us, you know, actually have helped us purchase things like this by saving money with parts that they've supplied for us. So thank you, Tron Pistons. Thank you, Web Camshafts. Thank you, Pro Valve Racing Products, Clutch Masters, everybody else that has basically stepped up to help with this project. And hopefully next year we could, you know, get it real close to being finished. So our next biggest thing is transmission. That's what we're gonna work on. We're gonna go to PRI, talk to the guys at G-Force over there. I've been dealing with them for, wow, since 1997. So we've always had a very good relationship with them. I wouldn't use anything else, only because they've treated us very well. So again, same as these guys, they didn't have to build us cranks, they did. I basically begged them to do it because they didn't want to do it with the economy and the way things were going. These things were ordered March of this year and they just came in. So, I mean, that's just how the name of the game goes. And compared to what we used to pay for these things, they went up $1,500. So that's on top of what we paid for the cranks. So, and I understand why they didn't want to do it. They basically didn't have, you know, the way the state of the world is right now, there's people don't want to work. And their biggest issue was they couldn't get work done for the stuff that they sold all the time. So they were big, you know, most crank guys are big into all the American stuff, LS engines, just everything else that they make that's American big block stuff, you know. So they basically told me, Brendan, I can't really stop what I'm doing to build you a crankshaft when I can't even build what I sell the most of, you know. So I got, and I basically told them, look, take your time. I'm in no rush. I can't do anything. I can't have a race program without crankshafts. I mean, that's just how it is. And by them taking the time that they did, it basically gave me more time to, you know, come up with the money and figure out how we wanted to attack our next steps, you know, moving forward with the race car and our race program. So we got them. I'm happy they're here. And just, man, you know, little by little, we'll get this race car coming back together. And I actually ported a head for it. That's already done. And just trying to get things knocked out. So I'll keep you guys posted, and I hope you enjoy it. And anybody has any interest, let me know. I can see if I can try and order more. It'll have to be a quantity order. And again, they will not be done anytime soon. So patience is key. All right, take care, guys.